I just want to reassure them that I love Rachel and I'll do everything in my power to make her as happy for the rest of her life as I know she is today. Gordon and May, why am I never crying? This is ridiculous. Gordon and May have been extremely welcoming towards me from the first time I met them. They're also great company on a night out, which is an added bonus. To be honest, I think I knew I'd get on with them and I fell in love with Rachel because I've helped her to be the person that she is today. Getting a bit of credit in the bank there. Okay, now on to Ian. Can't let today go by without thanking my dad for all his love, support and advice. And Christ, does he give out advice. And also for welcoming Rachel to our family. I know it's hard to believe, but I haven't always been his handsome, intelligent son, who is athletic, wise, and the modest man you see here standing in front of you. Over the years, my dad's helped me more than I deserve. He's seen me through thick and thin, mainly thick, to be honest with you, but I really hope I've done him proud today. Real couldn't have asked for a better dad, and I thank you for everything you've done and all the sacrifices that you've made. You're not escaping, Mona. I also wish to thank Mona, my dad's girlfriend, for all his support over the last few years. Mona, you make my dad so happy, and that makes me very happy. So, time for another toast, but we'll stand for this one. I'd like to propose a toast to parents, so please all raise your glasses to parents. Next. Organising this day has mostly been great fun, but we've not done it without lots of help. Yeah. Rachel's two bridesmaids, Kim and Kate, and we'll thank you all for what's done today. Have been a great help to us prior to the wedding. So thank you both. I would also like to thank our ushers, Ben. Yeah. They've been a great assistance today. Also, big thanks to Sarah and Kathy for the reading through the ceremony. Special mention has to go to Rosanna. Rosanna's helped Rachel with numerous things to do at the wedding, all the wee sort of arty things. Such like seating plan, which isn't bought, Rosanna actually made that. And she also sits close to Rachel at work, so no doubt we'd be putting up the Rachel's moans and stressed about the wedding plan. So thank you, Rosanna. Final thanks has to go to my best man, Andy. For all this help. Here on ice, an immense start weekend in Lisbon. Yay. I loved every minute of it, even the torture, the bloody paintball. As a sign, a great weekend has been had by all, when the recovery actually takes longer than the weekend itself. But thanks for that, Andy, it was great. So it's no toast, but just a round of applause for the welcome. Well, I suppose I should have a few words now about the lady to my left. The star of the show, Rachel, my wife. When it comes to her good points, where do I start? She's gorgeous, she's intelligent, she's generous, hardworking, she's popular, and a fantastic judge of character. As you've already heard today, I first met Rachel over 7 years ago in the pub. She was on a watch night out, I was on a separate watch night out. The groups got merged together and I was lucky enough to end up sitting next to Rachel. I just remember thinking how easy it was to chat, get on and have a laugh with her that night. As you may all know, Rachel can talk for Britain. No. But on that night it was definitely a two-way conversation, which has never happened again. Anyway, we exchanged numbers, and again, you've heard this already, but I think it's fair to say that I was a bit more keen than Rachel was. I text her, but it took Kate to persuade her the next day to text me back, if you can believe that. But anyway, text me back she did, and that's why we're here today. So, I'd like to thank Kate again, because if it wasn't for you, none of this would have happened.
Yay!
Rachel, or should I say Mrs. Watson? I couldn't believe my luck when you agreed to go out with me. I just love how much fun we have together and how great my life is with you in it. You're someone I come to time and time again for advice, which is almost nearly spot on. Rachel, you're a beautiful bride, beautiful person inside and out. Not only have you taken on me, which isn't bloody easy, you've taken on Kathleen and Ben, who both love you immensely. I've had my ups and downs over the years, but you've always been there for me, no questions asked. The constant love and support you give me makes me feel like we can take on any challenge life throws us.
No, don't go again. No. Give me a moment.
Dougie, you're not getting tears. Sucking up. Rach, I don't think I've ever shied away from telling you how much I love you. I know most people here today have a story of them to tell about my drunken declaration to them about my love for you. But I hope that by marrying you today, in front of everyone I care about, you'll see just how much you mean to me. You know that I always talked about my plan, and I think you eventually thought I didn't have a plan. But today was always the plan. I'm so proud to be a husband, and I want us to grow old and great together. I love you, baby. So, for one last time, I ask everyone to stand up and raise your glasses to join me to toast my beautiful wife. To Rachel.